Jimmy gone up to bed?
Yes. What's the calf like?
Ah, little beauty. Mother and daughter both doing well.
Oh, good.
Oh, don't bother with the clearing up, love. I'll get up a bit earlier in the morning and give a hand.
Oh, thanks.
Sit yourself down.
Oh, perhaps you're right. Party went all right, didn't it?
Ah, it seemed to. Mm. But, you know, looking round at them all makes you think back over the years.
It does.
Here, hand us the poker, Doris.
Phil and Chris and Jack and Walter and Tom. Yeah. We've got a few memories to...
Pictures in the fire.
Yeah.
Ah, Chris, such a tiny little baby.
She was 7.5 pounds.
But who'd have thought we'd stand one day and see her going hell for leather in a point-to-point race?
Oh, yeah.
Do you remember that finish? When she was riding Dawnbreak and she and that horse, Monty, and the big grey were fighting it out at the end? And that was a picture in the fire to remember, all right. Good old Chris.
What about Jack and Peggy? Remember the night our first grandson was born, Dan?
Anthony William Daniel.
Yeah.
Jack was in a state that night.
I remember trying to cheer him up. Yeah. Mrs. Perkins was helping the doctor and midwife, and I was brewing up tea as usual.
Quiet, Mum, quiet.
Eh?
I can't up that rail.
Oh, Jack, for pity's sake, sit still and relax. That's the fifth time you've got up and sat down again for no reason. And that's the fourth cigarette in about 10 minutes.
It can't take all this long. Doctor said it'd be all over when he went up. He's been up there 30 minutes already. What is he doing?
Better go up and ask him. Tell him how to do his job. I'm telling you, Jack, I heard the baby cry 10 minutes ago when you went out for that bucket of coal.
Well, then what's wrong? What do you think? Is it twins?
No, they're just making everything ready for the proud father to go up. Hear that? There it is again.
I heard that. I heard
it. So there you are. Boy or girl, it's arrived all right.
Is Master Jack there?
Oh, Mrs. P. What's happening? What is it? Is everything all right?
Yes, you can go and see her now and tell her how proud you are of both of them. It's a fine baby boy, 8 pounds. And you and me have got a grandson at last, Mrs. Archer.
Well,
congratulations, Jack. Well, go on up.
Oh, righto.
Hello, Jack.
Hello, Peg. You all right?
Of course I'm all right.
Good. I'm glad.
Getting worried?
Bit.
Oh, silly you. What you looking at?
You. Seem such a... Well, such a long time since I saw you.
But you haven't looked at Anthony William Daniel yet. Look.
Eh? What? Golly, you mean it really is a boy?
Of course it is. Isn't he beautiful?
Gosh, aren't we clever, you and me?
Our first grandson.
Yeah.
And now he's nearly 8 years old. It makes you think.
Mrs. P and I were thrilled to bits.
Good old Mrs. Perkins. She doesn't half give old Walter some stick lately.
Oh, she's been a great comfort to him, though, over the years. Remember when he lost those ewes at lambing time, Dan? When that sheep worrying dog did all that damage.
And Mrs. P was sitting there in Walter's old farm kitchen, trying to feed the orphan lambs with babies' feeding bottles.
I can see her and Walter now, after that awful night.
Ma'am, I believe as these little lambs ain't the only ones that is crying, there's a tear in your eye.
Of course there is.
You mustn't let it upset you, ma'am. They'll be all right so long as they've fed.
Not so much them I'm crying for, Mr. Gabriel. It's you.
Eh?
You want a woman round the place, Mr. Gabriel. It isn't a man's job tending for these poor little things.
Perhaps you're right, ma'am. Times like this, I got to admit a woman's gentleness is very welcome.
Never mind. We'll pull you through, Mr. Gabriel. Never let down a friend in need yet. We'll pull you through.
You'd have thought they'd have settled down together after that little lot?
No, they're a funny couple. Too independent, I think.
But I prefer to remember Walter when he's comical. Do you remember the time when Tom Forrest came home from jail after being acquitted on that murder charge?
When Walter laid on the village band. Oh, I'll never forget that, never.
There we were in the car, just approaching the bridge at the end of the village.
Yes.
Tom and me and Phil. And then it started. That was Walter.
Yeah.
Why, Dan, Phil, that's for me.
That's it. It's a reception in your honour, Uncle Tom.
Right, Tom. Switch off your engine, Phil. We got to open the doors in it proper.
Right.
Oh, I don't know, I'm sure. Expected nothing like this.
Walter's idea. Have you got that rope fixed, Walter?
Yes, Phil. Off you go now, chaps. Leave.
There's Doris waving them.
Eh? Where?
There, look, with Chris.
Oh, yes, so she is. I can't see all that clear.
Sun in your eyes, Uncle Tom?
Yes, Phil, the sun in my eyes. Well, who'd ever have thought it? I never noticed blokes felt like that about me in my trial. Does the fellas aren't good. And look, there's Prue. Hello there, Prue.
I'm blessed if she doesn't look as if she'd been crying, Tom.
Eh? And so she is. By golly, Dan, I don't know when I ever felt before as though I was likely to start blubbing myself, darn it. Walter, you old varmint, you shouldn't have done it. But what a lovely thing to do for a fella.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you very much.
Oh, well, memories.
Aye, pictures in the fire.
Yeah.
And the fire's as good as out now, love.
Oh, so it is.
Come on, let's go up and dream about them, shall we? It's been a grand night, and tomorrow's another day. Up to bed, then.
Yes, I think so. Put the lights out.
Aye. Hang on for me, then. I'm coming.
Yes, right-ho, Dan.